Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. So welcome to our Sravana Utsava festival. His Holiness Bhakti Gauravani Swami Maharaj is going to speak on Vaishnava songs. So aaj ke amader Sri Srimad Gauravani Swami Maharaj acharya der bhajaner upore baktobyo rakhben. তো মহারাজকে আমরা স্বাগত জানাই তিনবার হরি বল বলে। তো আমরা উই উইল অল ওয়েলকাম টু মহারাজ বাই চ্যান্টিং থ্রি টাইমস হরি বল।
Thank you all for coming. So how do? You do a simultaneous translation? Or do I have to stop? So I don't have to stop and everything goes on.
So asha kori amra apnader kache radio ache FM. Hope that everybody has brought their FM. So please tune it to 95 Russia and Bengali ache 90.
Okay.
Kojon Bengali ache? Okay. Russian? Okay. So translation is going on 95. Okay.
German? Any? Only one? Okay. Spanish? No. Espanol? Again? So we start, right? Thank you. Hare Krishna. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Diti Namine. Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pacharine Nirvishesha Shunyavari Pashatya Desha Tarine. So we will speak about the songs of the Vaishnavacharyas. We have here on the left Narottam Das Thakur, in the middle Srila Bhaktivinod Thakur and Lochan Das Thakur. There are many more, of course, and Srila Prabhupada did sing songs of many different acharyas. These three are, we can may say, the most prominent. Most of the songs Srila Prabhupada sang are from Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Narottam Das Thakur, and from Lochan Das Thakur, mainly two, Paramakaruna and Nitai Guna Mani. That's the recordings we have. I'm sure Prabhupada may have chanted more songs on his own. So let us start with the supreme musician, Krishna. He plays the flute. I don't know whether he sings songs. Probably he does, with his cowherd boyfriends and with the gopis probably. But he is most famous and known for his flute playing. And he can speak through his flute and influence the hearts of all those who hear. As it is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, those living entities who are moving, when they hear Krishna's flute, they become stunned. They stop moving. And those who are non-moving, like trees and plants, etc., when they hear the flute, they start to move. And even the stones, it is said, they start to melt. So there's a very wonderful effect of hearing the sound of Krishna's flutes. So we will speak about sound, because that's the important part, obviously, of any song or any music. And Srila Prabhupada, he talks about this, and he said that we want to hear good music. Everybody likes to hear good music, melodious music. And if we engage our ears in hearing melodious music in relationship with Krishna, then in time our ears will not want to listen to any other type of so-called very nice mundane music, because the effect is parang drishva nivartate. One will have a higher taste. Here we have two pictures. Srila Prabhupada on the left is in San Francisco, 1967, and the lower picture is 1974 in Germany, where we recorded with him the Krishna Meditation album. Every morning after breakfast, Prabhupada would come. We had made a small studio, very amateur, not very professional, and everything was direct. There was no rehearsal. We just put on the microphones. Prabhupada selected a song. He had a small songbook, and he just started to play. And the result is quite surprising, actually. So, in the early 70s, one of Prabhupada's early disciples, he came to Mayapur, Achyutananda Swami at the time. And he learned Bengali, he learned to play the Midranga, and he learned the Bengali songs. And he was the first one to make recordings, and they were sent to our centers. And that's the first time we ever heard any of the Vaishnava songs, because we didn't know any of them. Only Hare Krishna and the Panchatattva mantra, basically. Govinda Jaya Jaya, that was all. So then we heard for the first time those Bengali songs, and then also they published a songbook. And when it was published, Prabhupada said, "I'm very pleased to see this collection of songs composed by Thakur Bhaktivinoda Narottam Das and the other great acharyas of the Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya." And he said that these songs are not ordinary songs. When these songs are chanted by pure Vaishnavas who follow the rules and regulations of Vaishnava character, then they are actually effective in awakening Krishna consciousness that is dormant in every living entity. So Prabhupada started to introduce these songs early in 1968, 1969. Most of the recordings we have are from that time. And many times after he finished the song, he gave a purport, which is basically a translation with some comments. So let us speak about the effect of music in general and what it means. There are different arts we have in human society. We have theater. Yesterday and the day before and the next days in the samadhi, Bhakti Mark Swami's theater group is performing many mothers and many fathers. And also there, one can feel an effect on the heart when those actors express emotions and thoughts and give a message. Then we have painting. Painting is a medium which is not very dynamic. You just look at it and then you may wonder what does it actually mean, especially nowadays. And in the past it was basically because there was no photography, so they painted whatever they saw so people could see something they otherwise they wouldn't be able to see. But an emotional response to this kind of art is rare. And then we have literature. And then, yes, if one reads sometimes, there may be something, and even people may cry when they read some love story. And finally, the lovers, like Romeo and Juliet, they drown and die. And oh, then we put the book away. And you know. So, but music actually is the most powerful medium. In music, there you can express thoughts, feelings, and desires, and those who hear it, they have an impact on their consciousness. Now you'll see a picture. I think everybody immediately knows where this took place. I mean, those who are older definitely know. Those who are a little younger may not. 1964-5 in London. Those who were doing the music, just four boys in their early 20s, they just had a little bit of music, and the effect, as you can see here, is very variegated. People respond in many different ways. So it depends on the level of our consciousness also when we hear some music, in what to what degree or how does it really affect us? So, George Harrison and the other Beatles, they had heard Prabhupada's first recording. This is a picture from 1966 in New York when Prabhupada recorded the what they call the Happening album. And as George Harrison explains, and it is you can read it in Shyamsundar's book, Chasing Rhinos with the Swami, how they actually got this record right after it was published, and from 1967 onward they were listening to it, and George Harrison and some of them even started to chant the holy name without having met any devotee yet. So music is very, very powerful. This is the record then, Shyamsundar, you see him here on the right side with the Dilruba together with George Harrison. So they recorded this Maha Mantra, and today of course we do have Govindam Adipurushang every morning in all the temples. So this recording also influenced many, many, many people all over Europe at least, and I think probably all over the world. I heard the Maha Mantra the first time in 1969. This record was published in August 69, so shortly afterward, because it was became very popular, it actually went to number one in many countries. So I also heard it, but I cannot say, I would lie to you, that I was immediately affected and became a devotee. But it stayed there, and of course later on, a few years later, then I did hear it more consciously. So let us see music in two ways generally. We have mundane songs, like pop songs and folk songs and opera and classical songs. They are meant to please the senses. There's only one message, just have a good time, entertainment. And then we have spiritual songs, just not only songs, mantras, hymns, prayers. They're meant either to glorify the Lord or to also address the Lord and transmit our feelings, or our desires, our longings. And we can see in the prayers or the songs of the acharyas where all these different aspects are manifested. Some of the songs do combine many different aspects. For example, also lamentation or self-reflection is a prominent part of these Vaishnava songs. So Srila Prabhupada, he made a statement. He said about the songs of Narottam Das Thakur that the sound is above the material platform. It's not from this world. It comes directly from the spiritual platform. And there's no need even to understand the meaning, but we will try to transmit the meaning also. And he compared it to thunder burst. When there's a thunder, then everybody can hear and immediately knows what it is. So the songs of the Vaishnava Acharyas are like that. They are not frightening like thunder maybe. They are pleasant and they are also enlightening. So it's an enlightening lightning. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Prabhupada speaks about the chanting, the singing of Vaishnava songs in a prayer by Prahlad Maharaj to Nrsimhadev. There, Prahlad Maharaj, he says the following. He says, "O my Lord Nrsimhadev, by engaging in your transcendental loving service in the association of devotees who are liberated souls, hamsas, then I shall become completely uncontaminated by the association of the three modes of material nature, and I will be able to chant the glories of your lordship who are so dear to me." I shall chant your glories following in the footsteps of Lord Brahma and his disciplic succession. In this way, I shall undoubtedly be able to cross the ocean of nations. So in the purport to this verse, this prayer by Prahlad Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada, he says the following. One should chant the bona fide songs received from disciplic succession. In Bhagavad Gita 4.2 it is said that the chanting is powerful when one follows the disciplic succession. Evang parampara praptam imang rajashayo vidu. Manufacturing many ways of chanting will never be effective. However, chanting the songs of the or the narrations left by the previous acharyas, Mahajano, Yena Gata Sapanta, is extremely effective, and this process is very easy. By following in the footsteps of the great acharyas, one associates with the hamsas or paramahamsas, those who are completely freed from material contamination. Indeed, by following the instructions of the acharyas, one is always freed from all material contamination, and thus one's life becomes successful, for one reaches the goal of life. So if we look at the songs of the acharyas, we can see there are different moods and different ways of expressing certain aspects of our life. So I have divided the songs in different categories. First of all, there are songs that are mainly introspective. Here are some examples: Anadi Karamafale, Manasadeha Geya Hari Hari Bifale Gopinath, also Bulia Tomare. And then we have songs that are instructive: Nitai Parakamala, Mana Shiksha, Jeev Jago, Bajahure Mana, O Gae, Gora Maruswane. There are prayers. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Doya Koromore. Every morning we sing this in front of Panchatattva. Ei Baro Karuna Koro, praying for the mercy of the Vaishnava. Then there's aspirations, Vigyapti. Ohe Vaishnava Thakura Gauranga Bolite Habe. Then we have glorification, Shuddha Bhakata, Narada Muni, Nitai Gunamani, Jaya Radha, Jaya Krishna, and also simply Nam Kirtan, just names of the Lord, Yashomati Nandana, Vibhavari, Shesha. And in many songs, different parts are actually in one. There are two main song books we know and we use. One is Bhaktivinoda Thakur's Sharanagati, but there's also Gitavali, Gitamala, Kalyana Kalpataru, many different. He has actually written about 300 songs, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And Narottam Das Thakur, we have Prarthana and Prema Bhakti Chandrika. Now, I looked in both of these songs, how do they begin? And it's interesting that both Sharanagati and Prarthana begin with humility, Dainya. So, in Sharanagati, the first song is, after the introductory song, Bulia Tomare, I have forgotten you. And the next one is Vijja Vilase, Vijara Vilase, also reflective. After Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he expresses in that song that I thought mundane learning was very important. He became very learned. And now I'm recognizing actually it's just a big burden. And I've become an ass, a very learned ass. So that's humility. One recognizes one may be so learned in also many mundane subject matters, but from the spiritual point of view, it's all useless actually. It's a big burden. And then Amara Jivana. Prabhupada sang both Bulia Tomane and Amara Jivana, which means my life. One looks at one's life, especially when you get a little bit older, you look back on your life and you say, how did I waste my time? And now I'm getting old, now what's going to happen? And in Prarthana, Narottam Das Thakur begins with Hari Hari Bifale, which is Prabhupada's favorite song. So we will begin with Bulia Tomare by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and then also Hari Hari Bifale, which are both songs, as you can now will see from the translation, introspective songs. So what happens is the acharyas, they put themselves into our place, they take our position, and they express what we should feel, how we should feel. We don't feel like that. You know, that's the problem. But they express how everybody in this material world, when they get a little bit introspective and reflective and honest, they will be able to feel the same as these acharyas do. So let's have a look at Bulia Tomare. Here you have an old man and the same person when he was young. So that's the situation. This is from Dainya, humility of the songbook Sharanagati, surrendering to the Lord's shelter. So Lord, I have forgotten you and come to this material world where I have experienced a host of sins and sorrows. So Srila Prabhupada, comments about this. He said, what is our position? Our position is described by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Jivaya Swarup Hoy Nitya Krishna Das. Actually, we are eternal servants of Krishna. But now, we have forgotten that. And therefore, Bulia Tomare Sangsara Asiya Peye Nana Vidya Vyata. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he speaks about this in one of his songs, and he says, my Lord, forgetting you, I have come in this material world and I'm simply suffering. Peyenana vida byata. We find the same expression in the Vedic literature, the same instruction from liberated devotees. We have forgotten what is our position, and temporarily, because we have got a certain body, I'm thinking I'm Indian, or I'm American, like that. But my interest is to be an eternal servant of Krishna. So therefore, the conclusion is, now I approach your lotus feet and submit my tale of wu. Now I tell my life story. While in the confines of my mother's womb, where I was bound up tightly in unbearable pain, you once appeared briefly before me, O Lord, but then you vanished again, leaving behind this poor servant of yours. At that moment I thought, after my birth, this time, I will surely worship you with undivided attention. But alas, after taking birth, I fell into the entangling network of worldly illusions. Thus I possessed not even a drop of true knowledge. As a dear son fondled in the laps of attentive relatives, I passed my time smiling and laughing. The affection of my father and mother helped me forget you still more. And I felt that this material world was a very nice place. That's the typical situation. Day by day, I gradually grew into a young boy and began playing with other boys. Soon my powers of understanding emerged, so I diligently studied my school lessons every day. Proud of my accomplished education, I traveled from place to place and earned much wealth. I maintained my family with due attention, but I forgot you, O Lord Hari. Now in old age, this Bhaktivinoda very sadly weeps as death approaches. I failed to worship you, O Lord, and instead passed my days in vain. What will be my fate now? So, that's the real situation. So it's good to remember, even if you have a young body and you still think, life is very nice, it's not so bad. I have strength, I have beauty, I have maybe even money, and so many other facilities for enjoyment. So this is all old people's talking. Well, your time will come. Just wait a little. It goes very fast. As Bhagavatam says, youth lasts for 3 or 4 days. And then it's gone like a flower. A beautiful rose blooms. And then after 3 or 4 days, the petals fall down. So intelligent person will not become bewildered, but will remember. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in this song, he expresses that feeling. So, we try Buliya Tomare. How many of you have sung and know this song? I'm surprised. So we will do, a melody I think everybody knows. And I hope...
Buliya tumare sansare asare vedana nidhyata buliya tumare sansare asiya hey anana yada tumara charane asiya chiya bolibo kena kata tumara charane Asiya chira Olivanu perakata Bulliya tomare samsare asiya Teye nana vidha yata Bulliya tomare jatare chilama jakona vishama bandana pashe janani jatare chilama jakona vishama bandana pashe janani jatare chilama jakona vishama bandana pashe Yeah. kahoya keli nu balansa kahoya keli nu Yeah.
So there are more songs like that. Anadikara Mafale is a very famous one. But let us continue with Hari Hari Bifale by Narottam Das Thakur. This is the first song in Prarthana, and it is according to a story that Yamuna Devi tells, Prabhupada's favorite song. Prabhupada came to England for the first time in 1969. There was no temple, so he stayed at John Lennon's estate, and the devotees were also, there was enough space, so they also stayed with him. And Yamuna Devi tells us that every morning Srila Prabhupada was chanting bhajans of the Vaishnava Acharyas in his room, and she was sitting down at the stairs and listening. So when Prabhupada noticed that she was there, he called her and he asked her whether she liked the chanting, and of course she said yes. So then at that time Prabhupada said that the prayers of Narottam Das Thakur are beyond the material atmosphere, and they can directly have an impact on our heart just like thunder. So at that time she asked, Yamuna Devi asked Prabhupada what his favorite bhajan was, and he said Hari Hari Bifale. This is in the park in that estate. So let us see the meaning of the song. O Lord Hari, I have wasted my life. Although I have taken this rare human birth, I have not served Radha and Krishna, thus I have knowingly drunk poison. The treasure of divine love in Goloka Vrindavan has descended as the congregational chanting of Lord Hari's holy names. Why did my attraction for that chanting never came about? Day and night my heart burns in the fire of poison, of worldliness, and I have not accepted the means for relieving it. Lord Krishna, the son of King of Raja, became the son of Shachi, and Balaram became Nitai. The holy name delivered all those souls who were sinful and thus suffering. The two sinners, Jaga and Madai, are evidence of this. O Lord Krishna, son of Nanda, accompanied by the daughter of Rishabhanu, please be merciful to me just once. Narottam Das says, O Lord, please do not push me away from your reddish lotus feet, for who is my beloved except for you? So the melody we will sing is based on Srila Prabhupada's recording of Hari Hari Bifale, and I adapted it in such a way, so I think we all, not very difficult to participate. Hari Hari Bifale Janamamarai, Hari Hari Bifale Janamamarai, Hari Hari Bifale Janamamarai, Hari Hari Bifale Janamamayai. Manushya Janama Paya Radha Krishna Nabajiya. Manushya Janama Paya
Like our ad-free videos? Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.